Rob with Precision Zone, and we're going to be doing a quick static check on this CIMR-P7 inverter from Yaskawa. So after the drive is powered off, you would like to give it some time for the DC bus to discharge before we perform any checks so we don't get any accidental electrical shocks. So now that the drive has been sitting for some time, you'll want to go ahead and put your digital multimeter on the DC setting, and then we're going to check between the negative and positive side of the DC bus. So we're going to take the negative side of our digital multimeter and place it on the negative side of the DC bus, and then we'll do this positive side of the multimeter to the positive side of the DC bus, and we're not showing anything at all. And that's because this drive has been sitting for a long time without power applied. So now that we've verified the DC bus has been discharged, we'll go ahead and move our digital multimeter into the diode check functions while we check the inputs and the outputs on the drive. We're going to start by placing the negative side of the digital multimeter on the positive side of the DC bus, and then the positive lead we're going to go between L1, L2, and L3. We're getting 4.6, 4.6, 4.6, and then we're going to reverse the leads and take the positive side of the probe and put it on the negative side of the DC bus, 0.45, 0.45, 0.45. Now these readings could be anywhere between 0.2 and 1 volt. The most important part about this check is to make sure that they're balanced across all three phases. So now we'll go ahead and move into the outputs, and we're going to perform the checks the exact same way. The negative side of the digital multimeter, the positive side of the DC bus, between U, V, and W, 3.7, nice and balanced, switch the leads, positive probe on negative DC bus, U, V, and W, nice and balanced at 3.7. So hey, the inputs and outputs on this inverter are checking great. One more test that we can perform is make sure that none of the phases are shorted to ground. So we're going to go ahead and put our meter on the resistance function and find a good ground and check between L1, L2, and L3 and UVW, making sure that there is no continuity. We'll take the negative probe, put it on a good ground, and we'll go RST or L1, L2, L3, and then we'll go U, V, W, or T1, T2, T3. So none of the phases are to ground, and the transistor module seems to be in good shape. Now, if you're still having a problem with this drive, please contact us at Precision Zone so we can help you further troubleshoot it. As always, thanks for watching.